In this module, we're going to talk about what's called the solubility product, or Ksp. So, I don't know if you remember, but back in first semester of general chemistry, we learned solubility rules. What those really are just a generalization of what we're talking about now, the Ksp, or the solubility product. And what that is, it's just another equilibrium constant, just like we've been seeing. And only it's for a specific type of reaction, and that is the solvation of an ionic solid in water. We always assume that water is the solvent, and we always assume that the temperature is 25 degrees Celsius, unless we're told otherwise. Because remember, the equilibrium constant, and Ksp is an equilibrium constant, does depend upon the temperature. So let's look at, for example, the dissolution of lead 2 iodide in water to make the lead 2 ion and 2 iodide ions. Remembering that, okay, this is a heterogeneous equilibria, and remember, we don't include solids or liquids when we write the equilibrium expression. And so if we're just write down what we know so far, the equilibrium constant for this reaction, we just get the concentration of lead 2 times the concentration of iodide squared. And that is all Ksp is for this particular reaction. And it ends up that for this particular reaction, the value is 1.4 times 10 to the minus 8th. We usually just don't use any units. There are tables. This is part of one. It has some, you know, these are the Ksps. These are the equilibria. These are the ionic compounds. There's some more useful to have. So, when we talk about the solubility of an ionic compound, we're talking about how much of that compound will dissolve in a liter of solution. Again, the solvent's going to be water, and it can be either in grams per mole or moles per grams per liter or moles per liter. If we're going from a Ksp, the Ks are given in terms of concentrations, moles per liter. So we will get the solubility in terms of moles per liter when we get it from the Ksp, like we're about to do right now. So let's say we wanted to find or calculate the solubility of lead 2 iodide in water, knowing that its Ksp is 1.4 times 10 to the minus 8th. Well, all we do is write down an ice table where we have no lead 2 or no iodide in solution yet. We put some solid. That's supposed to be a solid there. Lead 2 iodide in water. And I'm going to use S instead of X. A lot of times we use that just to show that it's the solubility. Now, the solubility of lead 2 iodide is how many moles will dissolve in a liter of solution. Well, because this is 1 to 1, however many moles of this that will dissolve, that's how many moles of lead 2 we get. But we get twice that many moles of iodide. So the concentration of iodide, the change is going to be plus 2 times the solubility of lead 2 iodide. Anyway, at equilibrium we'll have S of lead 2, 2S of iodide. And so plugging into the equilibrium expression, Ksp, we get S times 2S squared or 4S cubed. Solving for S, and we know what Ksp is. Solving for S, we get 1.5 times 10 to the minus 3 moles per liter. Because S is how many moles of lead 2 iodide will dissolve in a liter, that's a solubility in terms of moles per liter. Now, if we want grams per liter, all we have to do is convert moles of lead to iodide to grams using the molar mass. Again, this 461.008 grams per mole, that's what I calculated for the molar mass of lead to iodide. And anyway, so when we multiply that out, units of moles cancel. And we get grams per liter, and it's about 0.70 grams per liter. That's how you do that. Go the other way, though. If we know the solubility of a compound, we can calculate Ksp. So let's say we know that the solubility of calcium phosphate in water at 25 Celsius is 2.56 times 10 to the minus 6th moles per liter. What's Ksp? Well, this is the equilibrium expression, and because for every 1 mole of calcium phosphate that dissolves, we get 3 moles of calcium and 2 moles of phosphate, at equilibrium we will have 3s of calcium and 2s of phosphate, again where s is the solubility of calcium phosphate. And so the equilibrium expression, the Ksp, will just be 3s cubed for calcium ion times 2s squared. squared for phosphate, but we know S, solubility, 2.56 times 10 to the minus 6. Plug that number in, and we get our KSP, equilibrium constant.